There wasn't much on the line for the Austin College football team today against Trinity, but it was a huge game for backup kicker Tom Thompson. You see, today's season finale would be the last chance for Thompson to score a point for the Kangaroos, which may not seem like a big deal until you consider that Thompson is 61 years old. Thompson and the Roos closing out the year against Trinity from San Antonio. 7-0 Tigers in the second quarter, but Philip Gonzalez gets loose down the far sideline, and he will dive into the end zone for the touchdown. And here comes Tom Thompson, the 61-year-old, for the extra point. It is up and it is good. Thompson is mobbed by his teammates. According to Austin College, he is the oldest player ever to play in a college football game. Congratulations all around for number 91. The Kangaroos lose the game, but the day is a victory for Tom Thompson.
I'm just glad I made it. Coach Gage said I wouldn't see my next birthday if I didn't, so I think it's good that I did.
It's not a stretch to say that today is the biggest day in the history of TCU football. If the number 4 Horned Frogs could beat number 16 Utah, they would be on their way to a BCS game and could even start to dream about a perfect season and a spot in the national title game. It's the Frogs and the Utes from Fort Worth and a sea of purple as we take to the field. In the first quarter, it's Matthew Tucker taking the handoff, and he runs away from the two Utes. 41 yards to the end zone, and it's 7-0 Texas Christian. We're tied at 7 when Andy Dalton finds Ryan Christian. I think he dropped something back there. Onward, Christian receiver. It's now 14-7 TCU. Now here's Dalton across the middle to Jimmy Young. He takes it down to the 1-inch line. Frogs punch it in, and it's 21-7. Here's Utah's Jordan Wynn, but he is intercepted by Tank Carter. 6 the other way, and the Frogs are on fire. TCU beats Utah 55-28. The Frogs are 10-0 and on their way to the BCS. Speaking of BCS, Texas had Baylor Bear meet for lunch today down in Waco. Cole McCoy and Jordan Shipley, friends, roommates, and touchdown makers. 7-0 Longhorns. The Bears driving, but Nick Florence is picked off by Aaron Williams in the end zone, and Florence wishes he were in Venice or something. Second quarter now, and Trey Newton, the son of former Cowboy Nate Newton, he weighs much less than his dad, rolls into the end zone, and it's 21-0 Horns. More from Texas. Wow, Jordan Shipley gets hammered by Tracy Robertson. Shipley goes down hard, but he would return to the game later that same drive. And the best revenge is living well. Shipley, the second oldest player in college football history. Just kidding about that. He makes it 28-0 Longhorns. In the fourth quarter, Florence is picked off by Eddie Jones, and that's 6 the other way. The Horns are also 10-0 as they roll the Baylor Bears 47-14. Two disappointing seasons collide as Texas A&M and OU meet in Norman. The Aggies have it, and then they don't. Christian Michael coughs it up, and Brian Jackson picks it up for the Sooners. 52 yards for the touchdown, and it's 7-0 Oklahoma. And then a little hooligaggery by the Sooners. I just made that word up. Ryan Broyles on the reverse. He will take it home, and it's 14-0 OU. Sooners rolling. It's 14-10 when Landry Jones hits Ryan Broyles in the corner. That makes it 21-10. And the Aggies are hurting. Chris Brown punches it in from inside the 5. 28-10 Sooners, and cover your eyes, Aggie fans. Oklahoma wins 65-10. On the Big 12 scoreboard, can a Pirate beat a Cowboy? It does not look like it right now as Oklahoma State leads Texas Tech 24-10 as they play in the fourth quarter. Nobody seems to want to win the Big 12 North. K-State loses at home to Missouri. Nebraska beats Kansas on the road, and Iowa State is bowl eligible after a win over Colorado.